Good evening. My name is Bob Dagis, Robert Dagis. I'm a resident of Jim Thorpe and a Republican. Speaking to TJ York and Bill Miller, who are candidates, two of four candidates for two positions at Penn Forest Township supervisor position. These people will be elected to a role in government that is a combination of the township borough, what we know as a township borough, and the mayor. It is a significant Democratic vote-relying position. And the people who are running for the office are Judy Knappenberger.
Knappenberger,
excuse me, incumbent Republican. Bill Miller, right here, Libertarian. Warren Reiner, incumbent. He did not show up tonight. And TJ York, a Republican. Now, both of you live in Penn Forest Township, is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay, good. So we're here in Carbon County at the Looking Glass Restaurant here on West Broadway. And it's about 7 o'clock p.m. on Tuesday night in September the 15th, 2015. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
I have some questions with regard to the Penn Forest Township supervisor position. That will be on questions that will be you'll be interfacing with if you get elected to the job. Question number one. Let me begin. Bill, I would like you to spend 3 minutes and introduce yourself to the people of Carbon County, to the people of Penn Forest Township. You're an auto mechanic, correct?
I am an auto mechanic.
Okay.
Yes.
You have 3 minutes, then Mr. York, I will give you 3 minutes. Thank you.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for attending tonight. My name is William Miller, and I am running for a seat in Penn Forest supervisor position.
I need a clock.
Why? Because I feel the local government needs more transparency in a township with a history of personal agendas being put into place no matter how the taxpayers may feel. I believe the citizens of our township would like to know about upcoming issues at future supervisors' meetings in advance. And with the internet capabilities of today, the feedback from our citizens could impact on how our tax dollars are spent.
Thank you. TJ.
Yes, my name is TJ, or Ted York. I also live up in Penn Forest. I am running for supervisor position. My ideals for what I would like to do is to have the transparency for people, use the internet if it's possible, and open doors and windows for everybody to be able to see what's going on behind the scenes as well. But there's been too many different things going on with the elected officials right now that are not being answered or tended to. I think the transparency of everything for people to be able to see it is most important. Thank you.
Thank you. Question number one. Bill.
Yes.
What is your opinion on the forensic audit on the misappropriated funds to the point of $1.6 million?
Well, in the last administration, prior to this administration, they approved the forensic audit. The new administration come in and they refused to do it. I believe this forensic audit should be done to put this to bed once and for all.
Thank you. TJ.
Well, my feeling is the same as Mr. Miller's. I'd like to see this be put to bed, but I'd like to know for sure what all went on. I'd like it in black and white. That's my agreement is with Mr. Miller on that.
So, three packages, you can't really quite sleep because you don't know what's what?
I can sleep well. It's the people that may have broke the law. They're the ones that are probably losing sleep.
Exactly. I think it's time to find out maybe some truth, which can be done, Forensic itself is, I think, a good thing.
Can you explain what forensic is to the people, Mr. Miller? Mr. Miller?
A forensic audit is an audit brought on by the DA looking for things that are sort of like, don't look right, okay? I mean, these guys do this all the time. And the minute they start auditing the books, they can tell if somebody's been pushed jobs, if things are on the up and up, and where the monies have gone, if they've gone anywhere at all.
He's, Mr. Miller is exactly right. Falling back onto receipts and so forth, everything should be accounted for. Every penny. It's like playing the lottery. You have to account for every penny in that, as well as the taxpayers should know exactly where every penny of their dollars are being spent. The forensic audit itself, I think, is highly important to come out with the facts for people.
Mr. Miller talked about the DA. You're referring to the county district attorney?
Yes.
Thank you. Question number two. With the Pennsylvania Turnpike here in the township, do you think the township's economy will improve? If so, what is your plan, Mr. Miller, to improve jobs at Penn Forest Township?
Well, first of all, we have to get an influx of people interested in that area.
Of job creation?
Well, first of all, you need the companies to come in to build. That's where we're at right now. It's kind of stagnant. Nothing's happening on that end. Once the businesses start coming in and showing interest, then we'll go through a procedure of what they're going to bring to the table and how it's going to help our economy as far as local jobs.
TJ.
He's correct on that as well. You have to see what's going to be brought in first. It takes time. You don't know everything right offhand what's going to be coming onto the mountain. If businesses and so forth would like to try to come to our area and create some jobs, then we have something to work with. In the meantime, we just have to wait and see how it's going to start working out.
So you're saying now with easy access is one thing, but still the job creation needs the capital infrastructure first.
Exactly.
Okay, thank you. Question number two. Mr. Miller, question number three, excuse me. With easy access from the turnpike, do you think crime will rise in the township? If so, do you support a regional police force instead of the Pennsylvania State Police in the future?
With an influx of traffic from the new exit, you could have help in the economy, and along with that, if the stores are there, the thieves are going to come. I believe the people of Penn Forest don't really need a police department. All they have to do is remain vigilant, and maybe these businesses could have in security, their own security officers. This way it's not going to burden the township. You know, because if you start talking police department, you're looking at $1 million plus a year. And that's money that the township would not have, and that would definitely drive us into a black hole. It would just suck us right under through the years.
Through tax increases?
Not necessarily tax increases. Well, the millage would have to increase to support a police department. But a lot of these townships are closing up their police departments because they can no longer afford them. Why would you want to start something like that if you know the... You see the end over from the horizon.
So you think the profile's already descript, so you need to think of something community-oriented or business-oriented?
Correct.
Security.
Correct.
TJ, would you like me to repeat the question?
No, Mr. Miller is correct with this.
Repackage the question for the people, please.
He's very correct with that. It is up to the individuals for Penn Forest to be vigilant in their own areas and so forth, to put out a police department and so forth. No. That would not happen right away.
Question number four. I understand that the grant money mostly built the park on 903. How do you plan to maintain the upkeep in the park in the future? Mr. Miller.
My question. Okay. You've been grossly misinformed about the grant money. I believe $562,000 of grant money has been appropriated, but the township already laid out $1.2 million, twice the amount of the grant. All right? And they're only in phase one. I understand bids from phase two are coming in at around $2 million, and there are no grants being written at this time. Reason being, the person that used to write the grants for our township was fired. So there's nobody there that really knows how to appropriately write grants. And the money is not coming in, and the taxpayers need to know that this big hump's coming. And at the last township meeting, I told them just scrap plant phase two and let's enjoy the park for a while.
Exactly.
Green grass and open space.
Of course.
Let me go back to you, Mr. Miller. I'm not trying to exclude you,
no,
TJ.
No.
Come back and reorient me if you'd like. But you're sculpturing an issue for me, okay? This is the first time I've really ever discussed this issue. I do not live in Penn Forest Township, okay? So you're saying deficit spending, which is a significant component, as what I understand is Keynesian economics, deficit spending is ruling the situation here.
Correct.
Okay. And is that healthy or unhealthy?
It's unhealthy at this time because when the park was initiated, there weren't supposed to be any tax money involved to create this park. It all was supposed to be done through grants and matching funds.
Grants and matching funds.
I understand the matching funds, but like I said, we shelled out 66% so far of this project, and only like 33% of it is grant money.
Thank you very much. Do you agree with that?
Yes, I do.
TJ,
he has nailed that right on the head. The figures even. Congratulations to some of that too, because you are correct on all that. So he actually said everything that was in my mind on it.
We have a park that's it's on our lap.
Yes.
And you're saying to manage it by how? Manage the future of the park by what?
Just getting in there to use the thing. The doors are open to the park already. There is I don't know which one it is, I believe it's the young kids soccer team is already starting to use the field. So use it. The doors are open on it.
Use it phase one.
Yes.
Thank you. The last question. How would you try to bring transparency into the government? Let me backdrop according to constitutional law. Article 1, Section 26 of the Pennsylvania Constitution Declaration of Civil Rights talks about equal distribution of the law with regard to civil rights. Do you gentlemen believe it is a civil right, the right of a citizen by high constitutional law to know the business of the legislature, which would be your job on the lowest level at Penn Forest Township? Yes or no? Mr. Miller?
Yes.
Yes or no? TJ?
Yes. Yes.
Is there a reason other than constitutional law that you are nodding your head and giving the right answer according to constitutional law?
I feel as though the people themselves, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
The right to know, they want everybody filling these out. When all the information is generally for the public knowledge. Wouldn't it be easier to extend that knowledge, what went on in the meetings, if someone would come in and ask a question, instead of constantly right-to-knows? It's a waste of time, a waste of, I think, taxpayers' money. It's very unfair for the people themselves. I think that you walk in there, it would make a better rapport between people that work there, secretaries, supervisors, and the people. You could leave there and say, oh, I already found out. I'm done. That's my honest opinion what this is.
Let me graduate that a little bit with a little bit of sculpture, and I'm going to let you field the question, Mr. Miller.
Okay.
Article 2, Section 13 of the Pennsylvania Constitution says that the legislative sessions are to be open, except when they are supposed to be kept secret. My understanding of that secret piece has to do with executive session. Do you think there's been abuse with regard to executive session in Penn Forest Township?
Yes, yes I have. Matter of fact, before this administration, I rarely even heard of executive sessions. They have an executive session before every meeting, or they have one prior to a meeting, or they go into an executive session after the meeting. Towards the end of the meeting, they make everybody wait outside for 45, 50 minutes, and then they finally let you go back in, and then they say, well, we had our meeting, personal matters were discussed, and then they adjourn. They don't tell you what they talked about. All they have you standing outside for 45, 50 minutes, waiting for them to, whatever, they're hashing something out, they're belly aching over something. But when you come back into that meeting, after waiting outside, you expect an answer. And when they tell you, okay, meeting's adjourned, we just discussed personnel issues, I'm like, well, something needs to be done. I believe transparency in our government. What's wrong with putting the minutes of the meeting on the internet, right on the website?
Thank you.
Put it on there, let the people see what we spoke about, and let the people see what's coming up in the future. Let them vote on what's coming up in the future. You know, let them see what you're going to be talking about at the next meeting. I think more people would get involved, you would get feedback from those people, and you can figure out a way to spend that money with the people's insight behind you. Not just do what you're doing. I mean, they hire you to be an elected body for them. But when you go in there, it's almost like there's friction every time you ask them a question, or they don't have the answer, or the question never gets answered. I've seen this time and time again, and it disturbs me. And I can go on and on, but it's transparency is what our township needs, and I think transparency is the way. And you have to expose yourself when you're in a political position like that. You need to be up front with your people. I mean, they elected you to be up front and hold down what needs to be done.
You're there to represent
exactly. The
people, not represent yourself
exactly.
Or your own business
exactly.
To make money your way and for your own family.
Correct.
And say the heck with everybody else, even with contracts. You should have at least 3 bids on a contract, however it seems like it always falls one way.
Well, so, we're trying to change that.
Yes.
Mr. Miller.
Yes.
Would you like to make a closing remark?
Yes. I'm doing this because I love where I live. Well, I'm doing this because I love where I live. I had a business. I was a businessman for 20 years down in Philadelphia. I moved out of Philly. I moved up here. I found a piece of land. I fell in love with the area. I sold my business. It was a successful business. Moved up here, and I don't know why I'm here. It has to be a calling. I mean, there's a reason that I'm here, and I hopefully feel that me trying to legislate and bring transparency to this township is maybe something I needed to do. So I really, 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 I go to the meetings. I've been going to the meetings for 5-6 years now, religiously. And when I go in there, they hate me. They hate me. Here comes Mr. Miller. Here comes Mr. Miller. Because I shoot from the hip. And I know when I'm being snowed under. Maybe they don't like that, but that's the way I was brought up. And I'm never going to change.
Thank you very much. Are you finished?
I'm finished. Thank you.
TJ, let you close. He opened, you close.
Yes. Well, for myself too, I also have the same feelings as Mr. Miller. And we have so many friends on the mountain. It's a terrible thing when you're sitting at home and you're realizing how many of your friends are getting very close to losing their homes not knowing why, mischievous things that are being done to them, permits that were supposed to have been done and taken care of, 10, 12 years down the road, the permits are reopened and have to tear things apart to recheck things. I care for the people on the mountain, and I do love my home up there. And that's about all I have to say. I want fairness for the people.
You men speak with passion and sensibility. I wish you the best of luck, and I'm regretful that two other contenders, incumbents, didn't come to share their opinions tonight. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a pleasant evening.
Thank you very much.
We'll enjoy some good food at the Looking Glass.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the folks at the Looking Glass who opened this restaurant up, set these tables up, and provided good food for the folks here at Penn Forest Township. Good night.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Bill Miller, and I am running for a seat as a supervisor for Penn Forest Township because I believe transparency needs to be brought to the table, and I feel it hasn't been done yet, and I would like to do that.
My name is Ted York. I'm running for supervisor in Penn Forest. Everyone knows me as TJ. I want to make it transparent in our municipality.